Hi, I'm Abdul from Infutor IT Solutions. Today in this video, I will try to cover how to design a business website by using Zoho Sites from scratch. So let's jump to the Zoho Sites. Let's search Zoho Sites. Click on it. Wait. So actually what you can do by Zoho Sites, you can build website like the way you want. It's very user friendly interface for designing websites. There are a lot of standing templates. You can choose the templates for your business category and you can get all the things ready. There are a lot of standing templates. And there are a lot of pre-built sections. You can just drag and drop there. There are visual editor or the website builder for the people who don't have any coding experience. They can easily design the website in Zoho Sites. So other useful features like page version, responsive template, member portal, share and auto-publish. So there are a lot of features actually there. So let's sign up for Zoho Sites. Click sign in or sign up. Oh, I'm going to sign it up. So there are two options. You can put your email, password, and you can do agree, or you can sign in using Google. So I'm doing by Google. So what you need to do, let's translate into English. Yeah, put your email KATERITE 07. Okay, I'm putting my password there. So just hold on, I'm putting password, it has copied here. Okay. Next. And it shows the post notification. So hold on. Yes. And it's loading. Okay, now sign up is complete. I'm going to sign in by Google. Let's click Google. Okay, I put my name, my country, just create an account. On it's loading. It's loading, just wait. Yeah. So what you need to do right now, just name your website. Put your desired name for your business, or you can associate later on with your domain, like we are putting in Infutor IT Solutions. Just what it should be, just choose your category. It should be general, business, portfolio, restaurant, education, sport, event, travel, beauty, finance, hospital or logistics, law firms, whatever you want, or you can choose a theme. So I choose its business and your desired theme. There are a lot of themes you can choose actually. So what I can do, I can choose any themes. You see, there are a lot of themes there actually. So what I can do, I can choose this one, and you can preview the live demo, what the preview actually before using it. It is just like this. This is modern website template. Or if you don't like this, you can switch anything you want. So I'm going to putting this on, and I'm going to customize this one. Hold on. Yes. So after that, you can choose your theme color. So I can choose it as orange. And what should be the welcome text? I'm putting it here. Then you can choose the font and the layouts of the website header. What should be the header of the website look like? I'm putting this one, the default one. And how the banner should be displayed? There are three type of layouts how the banner should be displayed. So I'm choosing this one, the middle one. Then hit finish. It's loading, just wait a bit. It will take some time. It's getting prepared everything in the back end. So at the first try, it will take some time. So this is just the introductions, and it will go through all the way to check all the interface. So I'm not going here. So this is the building blocks. If you click here, you will get all the building blocks. So I'm going to skip it. The first thing you need to do, you need to click on the settings, then go to preferences and put your site name and that subheading or the slogan for your business. You can put, like, we can put automate your business with Zoho, this one. And we can show the heading, logo, menus, breadcrumb. If you want, we can show it. If you need sidebar, you can put it as so. If not, just save it. And if you think you need to put the contact information and logo, I'm going to put my logo here. I'm going to change it out, and I'm going to put my own logo. So if I go here, download the images, hold on. And I'm going to change it out. So upload your logo, go to desktop. This is my logo. Logo upload failed. Upload is complete and it shows failed. Let me check it. Let's wait. Rename it. Yes. Okay, it's such invalid content types. It will take only the valid image of the logo. Let me check it. Okay. Only the PNG version I'm going to put. Save logo. Just wait. And I'm going to upload each. This one. Yeah. Okay, this time successful. Just I need to put the upload favicon like this. And there is a favicon. What I can do, I can copy it or I can crop the favicon images. Okay. I'm putting it as favicon. So upload favicon. It should be 64 by 64, or the dimension should be 125 into 125. That means it should be a square image. So what I can do, okay, let me search the favicon. Yeah, this one may I use for favicon. So in desktop it's favicon. So now go to the website and upload your favicon. Yeah, this is the favicon. Hold on. Yeah, this one. Now it is successful. So what you can do right now, you need to go to the contact information. Here you can put your email and phone number if you want. I'm putting my email. Eka there at rate. Okay, this is my email, and I'm putting my phone number in an international format. 8801733. Okay, save it. Okay, now please check it. So you see, this is my email. This is the phone number, and this is the social icons. So what I can do, you see, this is the name of the site and this is the slogan. So I want to hide that two parts because it's the iteration is the logo. So let's minimize the logo size. It's okay. So what I can do right now, I can go and want to hide that part. So how I can do it? Settings, preferences, hide this one and this one. Heading and subheading is being hidden. So let's check. So you see it's hidden. Now I want to put the email, phone number and social icon into left and right. So well, I can put the social icon to the right. Let's click settings, go to visual editor. Just wait. Now we can go to the header sections and we can change it like this. Yes, it's changed, and the email, phone number, and the social icon are on the left and right side, and it looks good. And if you want, you can change the top bar theme color to light color. Yes, now it changed to the light color. So you can change it to any color, and you can choose the color presets by custom with the color codes. So if I choose this color with this one, so let's select PG. What is the color actually here? Yes, this one I can put here to match the logo color. Okay, hold on, it's not changing. So let's pick the color of the logo correctly. Yeah, this one. And I'm going to change the color code here. Yes, this one. Yeah. It is being changing in the back end. Just wait. Yeah, wait. Now you see the logo and the navigation bar color is same. Same you can do. Now what we can do? Yeah, it's okay. Now save it. Or if you want to change the menu color to bold, we need to go to advanced settings, header sections, go to header menu, and then from here we can change our text color and size. So it should be, I'm changing the color should be white, but let's change the text to letter. And it should be regular, and size should be 14. Let's save it. Okay. So if you think you want to put your Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter icon associated, now click here and go to whatever you want. Or if you want, you can delete, then save. Or if you want, you can reorder them also. So the header section is okay. Now I'm going to footer. Okay. Edit your footer. And here in the footer, we can change the logo to. Oh, sorry. Where is the fav icon? Okay, let's upload the fav icon again. And this was the fav icon. Save it. And you can put in Peter right here something else, whatever you want. Relations. You can put your tagline here. I can copy this line. Put it in Google, copy and update this line here. Yes. So here you can put something about your company. So hold on. So you can copy this paragraph, you can paste it here, copy, and you can update here. You see, it's okay now. And here you can link the social icon, click here, and you can link here like web URL https://fb.com. Yeah, rights reserved in Peter IT. Peter IT solution. Now, in the contact section, you can put your phone number, email, whatever you want. Actually, you can put the menu here. If I delete it, yeah. 403. This one, if you think, hold on. Add elements. I'm putting menus here. Where is the menu? Okay. And this is my menu. If you want, you can create the new menu, but I am putting the default one, add. In menu setting, there are a lot of separators like this. Or you can hide it and put it vertical instead of horizontal. Or you can change it. So it looks good. And for contact section, address, Dhaka, Bangladesh. Phone. Put your phone number here. Okay. It should be plus 8801733. Okay, you can put your email or whatever you want. Okay. Well, I don't need anything else. If you don't need, you can delete or skip those section. Or then here you can put the necessary things. If you don't have news, you can delete the news sections. Okay. But if you think you want to change the background color of the footer, then click here. Click three vertical lines. Click general. Select background type. You can choose solid color, background image, or background video. Whatever you want. If you choose the background video, it shows the video in the background. If you choose the solid color, it will show the solid color. You can change the color. You see? Any color, it's suit for you. Okay? So I'm changing back it to black color. Okay. I'm putting 000. It's a black color. Okay? And you can minimize the space between the icon, and here it should be And you can delete the unnecessary space from here. Now it's okay. Okay, if you want, you also add the separator or shaper. There are a lot of shaper I can add on the top. Set shaper, this one. Yeah, you can minimize the height of the shaper. Okay, you see the height of the shaper and it looks good. And even you can change the color of the shaper. Change color from shaper and it should be top type shaper standard. Yeah, now the color of the shaper has been changed. So the footer and header has been set up for your websites. Now you can set the banner, you can create the section and many other things. So in this video, I just show you the how to set up the heading and footer of the Zoho Sites and how to create it from scratch and change all the necessary informations. And in next video, I'll show you how to design the page section for your business. Thanks for watching this video.